be able to host the relaunch of Itazu Nursing Sahab's book, which is now 6 decades acquainted, as you corrected me yesterday. So we hope that as our eminent artists, art scholars, art critics will tell us, will throw light on his works and the different stages that his work has gone through. So we start now with the introduction of Mrs. Musarrat Hassan, and then we go to Mr. Quddus Mirza, and then Itazu Nursing Sahab will do the rounding off of his works. Okay, now we start with Professor Dr.
Musarrat Hassan, who's actually the author of the book also, and who has first-hand knowledge of some of these paintings, the situation, the circumstances. Okay. She herself is a very eminent scholar, a very well-known painter, and a renowned educationist. Dr. Musarrat Hassan has authored 5 books on art, and each one of them has been very well researched and very sought after because they're all out of print now. She has been an active volunteer member of the Pakistan Girl Guides Association for more than 3 decades. She has been the chairperson of All Pakistan Girl Guides Literary Effort, and she has also been afforded the President's Award of Izaz-e-Fazilat for academic distinction. I will now pass the mic to Dr. Professor Musarrat Hassan so she can apprise us about the works of Professor Itazu Nursing.
I'll tell you the rationale behind the book. Then I'll run through the various stages, various decades of painting, and maybe you will be able to see with me the various styles that Itazu Nursing has painted in. I, of course, was in a position to see everything, so I can give first-hand account of that. Achha, the rationale behind the book, there have been 70 years of Pakistan, and during those 70 years, we have treated our cultural heritage in a way that dushman bhi nahi karta. Kisi ne usko sambhalne ki koshish nahi ki. We have also watered it, wasted it, and it is hardly there for anybody, our future generations to see. If we as a nation are to emerge or re-emerge or resurrect, I think we need to, people over here in this, in these rooms should take charge of that heritage. We have done our bit. Itazu and I have been striving for really literary art, the art scene, the art heritage. I have, as Seema said, written 5 books on artists to try and preserve at least some of the works so that public viewing ho jaye. Everybody knows about Chugtai because Chugtai ki chaar paanch kitabon mein uski chhapi hui hai tasveerein, sabko nazar aati hai. Hamare to kisi ne itna bhi nahi kiya ki hamare itne great artists usme hain, unke bare mein likh ke koi kitabein chhap de. To meri, I started with the painting done during 150 years before partition, but then I continued with 5 artists. So, थोड़ा सा मेरा ये खतरा है इस काम में, इस कोशिश में. तो I but hope that others will follow. So I'll run through the first 20 years quickly. The first 20 years of Itazu Hassan's paintings were explorations, explorations in different styles. Next, you see his basic sense of color, sense of design comes through, but he is exploring every possible style. Yeah,
point out hoga just next aap mujhe
would you spend 20 years old and senior Cambridge mein school boy the and he was selling paintings like hot cakes in those days so these are the eventful then came a period of about 2-3 years when he went to England and fought with the establishment over there and couldn't paint for 3-4 years. But when he came back and joined National College, then he started again. But you know, he went back to the basics. He started by meticulously learning to draw once more, learning or relearning or starting to draw again. And he did a number of still lifes which were realistic and very accurately done. Next. These are the two still lifes I've included. Okay, then an accident happened in his studio. While he walked in the studio one day, he saw a rag lying on the floor. And he just took his brush and he started painting that rag. Then rag translated into ribbons, into patterns, into colors, playing around. Next. Which color plays to which color vibrates. It literally is luminous. That is what the next painting is all about. Next, this one. You see, he was also at that time thinking that art is too far removed from the common man. He wanted to use images that the common man used in order to reach out somehow. He felt that if you are painting, you must have paintings that relate to people. So he used mass-produced images and he brought them to life with this vibrant color. Next. This is paper tigers. Next. This has, I am sorry, this the vibrant colors have not come in this slide. It's a very vibrant painting and it is, the vibrant colors have not come out. I suppose sari katti.
We can imagine color.
Vibrant color. So then from there, he, you see, when you think about the common person, you start relating to them. You start relating to their problems, to their miseries, to their things. So, he started his political paintings, that is in the 70s. In the 70s he started, next one. This is when the war of Bangladesh happened. This painting is called Face to Face. The ugliness on both sides. It is face to face and I think it makes a statement. Then again there is the Bangladesh, three paintings, next. No, this is not, this is again, this is political activism. Next, this is the Bangladesh. This is the Bangladesh saga. If you remember 1971, there was flood in Bangladesh. That is that blue picture. Then the aftermath of the flood. and then army action in the third region. So this is his response to that. Next, this is again, I'm sorry, the slide is so small, I don't know, sari badi badi hoti, ye choti ho gayi. Halanki it's a big picture, but ye ho gaya. You see, this is when they announced, I think, I don't know, which ruler announced the Green Revolution. You see, but he's painted the Green Revolution behind, but the hungry people are still there. The presence, the overwhelming presence of hungry people. So this is that.
Next one.
This is hunger and, you know, peace walking at sort of. This again is My Lai Massacre. This was a moment in history that was very, very sad. A whole village was massacred, and this was his response to that. Next. This again is a comment on a fashionable, beautiful on the surface culture that in fact translates into that.
Butt of the gun.
Butt of the gun. The rifle butt. These are two attitudes to women. You see, one when she is treated as a commodity, and in the background is a woman of substance who has taken on three roles. She is a mother, she has a book, and she can also fight for her freedom. So this is with the Fukuoka Museum in Japan, and they have done so much research on it.
This is not our woman, this is how men perceive our women.
She was poor thing, left destitute, and so this is a painting he did at that time. I'm sorry I couldn't get the colored picture. Wo aadhi koi le gaya aur aadhi koi. So I couldn't produce half painting. Achha ji, next, these are men, the martial law, jail scenes and bars in which, and these bars seem to be a motif that he has adopted in many, many later pictures. Even when they are sceneries, beautiful pictures, he has these bars as a reminder that inside and outside, if you are enclosed in a space, you have to get out to be part of that scene. Otherwise, you are away from it. So, this is again our next. These are again scenes from the jail. Four inmates of jail with jars had. And this is a, again, our children outside. And their father inside, and Mustafa is there too. This is this was again martial law, Ziaul-Haq's martial law. And this is called Bouquet 84. Mati Jazi was saying New Year Bouquet. So he, that was a time, that was a time when his paintings were taken down from exhibitions. You know, at that time, there were no private galleries. There was the museum or there was the Alhambra. And his paintings were, because they said that they are too politically suggestive, so they took them out. And that is the time when he started painting in metaphors and in symbols. some of the symbols are, you see the green tree is Pakistan. It is lush green, it is flowering, and look at those parasites clinging to it and eating away its energy. These are again and again in many of his paintings later on. He was painting these symbols and trees on several levels. For instance, there was but there was also the trees that had, that showed resistance, that showed, you see, there are many trees, for instance, he writes in one of his articles, he's been writing articles also, and he writes in one of his articles that the laburnum, at one point of time, it is a dead tree. It has no leaves and the branches seem as if ye mara ke mara. Lekin, what happens is that suddenly there comes a time when it sprouts, buds, and suddenly there is color all over, and yellow all over the place. So laburnum is a tree that he used for struggle and for resurrection. Kikar is another tree that he used. Next. These are kikars, various kikars that he did. Then again, he did cubes from windows with bars. You see, this is a tree outside our. Next, ye bhi choti si slide hai. This is a tree outside. So his paintings were deceptively beautiful on the surface, but the message in this is a theme that runs through many of his paintings, and that is pehmasta rahe shajar se umeede bahar rakh. You see, cling to the source, and inshallah bahar will come. So these are the aage chale. These are all pevastha rahe shajar se. Pevastha. Here's a bird, engaged bird. But again, umeede bahar is the flowers are again symbol of hope. Ye sari wo umeede bahar wali hai.
There was turned into.
Then this is the time when he was exploring various other motifs as well. This is a few of the laburnums. Let's see the laburnums first. Oh, something else. He explored the motif of the mountain, the snow, the autumn, flowers as a motif. There are many, many of these. Sorry, ये छोटी बड़ी slides हैं. Next, हाँ, now, then I have also collected together all the murals that he painted. So this is a sketch he did for the NAFTEC. Cinema was the theme, and they commissioned him, and he painted the next. This is the mural that he painted. This is a, you see, it is reality. And what is reality? It has to explain what is this painting, technology. It's too complicated.
Since it was cinema, I tried to create an illusion. This is a street scene, and this was supposed to be displayed at the floor level. And these figures are about 5 feet, 3 inches. So that people were walking in front of this mural also become part of the mural, you know. And it was never displaced properly. It is a long story, or it was sold off along with the NAFTEC cinema and all the parts.